Yo, what is up, guys? This is your boy Micro. Thank you all for watching if you are starting to watch this right now. I wanted to start something new, maybe tutorials. I saw, shout out to Smitty. Smitty Concepts is a very good friend of mine. He's been a supporter of my designing for a very long time. He put out a video of doing a AVI, and I was like, hey, why not I do it as well? So, I'm kind of interested in doing it too. So let's get started here. All right. So what first we're gonna do is open a team logo. What I'm gonna do is maybe choose set. All right. So what we're first gonna do, let's see. I don't like the background, so I'm gonna delete the background. We're gonna delete all this lighting stuff because we're going to create our own CC. So no worries about that. Delete the text. Oh, this is just a 3D thing. Interesting. All right. Well, I'll use that. All right. So what we're first going to do is pick up a image. Many of you may or may not know, I am a huge fan of SpongeBob. So one of my favorite, by far my favorite person is Patrick Starr. Look at, see, I already have him right here. So I'm gonna use him in my AVI. I do have other AVIs that I want to use as well, other pictures, but I'm just gonna use Patrick in this case. Also, if you guys are interested, I will also do tutorials on lots of other stuff that are in my speed arts and stuff. And if you're interested, just let me know, comment below, or send me a Skype message. Let's see. I think it's more down here. There it is. Right here. Alright, so what you see here, this is for beginner designers. If you're already a well-known designer, you probably already know this. You see that this is locked because it is a JPEG file. So what you're going to want to do is press Control-Command-J, and then... and then just take it into the other thing, the other photo image file. Oh, so what I just did as well is zooming. I use my wireless mouse. It has its own scroll wheel. So what you want to do for that, for many designers, they click this button right here. It is unchecked once you press Control Command K, and then you just press that and then click this button right here so you can zoom a lot faster than using the magnetic tool, magnetizing tool, whatever. So what we're first gonna do is first lower the size. You know, actually, I'm actually gonna create this the background first. Maybe make this bigger. And then create a second one, Control Command J. Put this on top of here. Make it a little smaller. So Patrick can actually be in it. A little smaller. Try to flip it so it can be like this. Alright, so from here we are going to press create clipping mask, right click clipping mask, and then see here, and from there you're going to press Control Command J, and from here we're going to go above all this, and what I'm gonna do to crop out is use right here, what you guys may see is this lasso tool. Don't press that, hold it and then press magnetic lasso tool. And then what you're going to do is zoom in and then start here. Then just let it, just move your mouse and then just let it go all the way. I'm gonna take a lot longer this, a lot quicker this time because I did do another recording of this, which is a lot longer. So I'm just gonna get it over with this way. Oh Lord. If you make a mistake, just press the button delete on your keyboard until you have it where you want it in place again. Alright. Just go here. Here. Sorry about that I'm actually quiet. I focus a lot when I do designing and gaming. So, alright, from here, you see this, you press Control X, Control Command V, and then it'll have it all separate from this thing. So you just press backspace or delete, and then you have this all by yourself. Now you just put this above the logo, above all of this. And you want to align it to where it was. Maybe just make it a little bigger. There you go. What I just did is press Control Command T. You can also do just press this little box to change the size and then maybe rotate or whatever. So what you see here is actually pretty ugly. What you want to do is lower the opacity just a little bit. And what I will do is use the, hold this, press the polygon lasso tool, zoom in and just cut around the logo wherever you see that it's outside of it. There you go. Then press backspace to delete that, and then make the opacity high again. And you see one little mistake I made is I didn't really make it that grand. So I'm just gonna lower it once again so you can see the stroke. Cut it little by little. And there you go. There's your set logo. So next, let's see. I don't think that really looks that good. No, that doesn't really look good with the 3D thing, so I'm just gonna use the normal. Next, what you're gonna want to do is get a font. By far, my favorite font. Gotta thank Griffin. Shout out to you, man, for hooking me up with this. Is a Bank Gothic Medium BT. By far, one of the best fonts that I love. You can just search it on Google, and you'll try to be careful find a good link for that. So I'm just gonna type in Patrick. Ooh, make the font a lot, I mean the lettering a lot bigger. Let's try, that's fine. Alright, so I'm gonna put it right in the middle, right here. Gotta clean this up a little more. Notice a little mistake there. Alright. So what you're gonna want to do for the Patrick is add the blending color overlay. Oh no, not color. Gradient overlay. Change the black to a light-ish gray. Right there is fine. Then add inner glow. I used to use stroke, but I don't suggest anybody use that anymore. It's kind of pretty bad now for me. I'm not really a big fan of it anymore. Let's see, let's make this a little darker of a gray so we can see it. There we go, that's fine. And then drop shadow. That looks actually already nice, so let's see. Looks good. We can delete this now. So for the background, you just want it mostly to look like just this logo and the name. The background is too easy to see as well, so what you're going to do is press Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And around 2.5 to 3 is fine. I'm actually going to do 2.5 so we can just see it a little bit more. So after that, you want to add a few lighting. What I suggest is to use vibrance. Vibrance will make this a little dark. I like it that it's 100. Saturation, maybe just about 10. That looks nice. Then don't put this above the font, because it'll affect the font color as well. I mean, right now it doesn't really look it's that bad, but it might affect it. Next, you'd like to do curves. Use this one for the light. Let's see, let's fix it up like this, and this one to make it the dark. That looks nice. Lastly, you'd like to use brightness and contrast. Brightness, don't want to make it too bright, so maybe just about 15. And the contrast, maybe about negative 10. That looks nice. Alright, well, hopefully you all enjoyed this tutorial. If you'd like to see other tutorials on SpeedArts, and soon during the summer, school's almost over for me. I'm going to put a lot of gaming videos once I get my DVR on Xbox One with my friend Azriel and all that. So hopefully y'all enjoyed. Let me know what you think, and let me know if you want more tutorials. It's your boy Micro, and I'm out. Peace.